Hey AP Langers, I'm Dr. Clark, and this video is all about how to write the synthesis essay on the AP Language and Composition test. Now, the synthesis essay is designed to be like a mini research paper right there on the AP Language and Composition test. Now, because you only have 40 minutes to write it, and you're not allowed to consult any outside sources, they don't let you go on the internet or go to a library and do any original research. What they do instead is they provide you with 6 or 7 sources that are right there in your packet, and your goal is to use those sources to synthesize those sources into a coherent argument about the prompt that they provide. Past topics for the synthesis essay have included things like wind power, eminent domain, the high cost of college, the relevance of libraries in today's society. It always centers around some kind of controversial issue that you're going to have to take a position on in your essay. They're going to provide 6 or 7 sources about that controversial issue. Some will be in favor, some will be opposed, some will be mixed, and some will be more informational. And what you need to do is select the best information from those 6 or 7 sources and synthesize at least 3 of them into a coherent argument about that topic. Now, when you see your 6 or 7 sources, a couple of them are going to be visual sources. Now, the first visual source is going to be statistical. It's going to be a quantitative source. What that means is it's going to have charts, graphs, facts, information, data, statistics, all things that you can easily incorporate into a synthesis essay in order to support one side or the other on a controversial issue. The other visual source is going to be different. It's usually a photograph, sometimes it's a painting, sometimes it's a political cartoon, but it'll be some kind of visual element that relates to your source. And again, it should be something that you could incorporate into a good argument about that topic. Now, the other 4 or 5 sources are just going to be nonfiction sources. They're just going to be excerpts from articles in certain magazines or articles in certain academic journals that are going to have information and arguments that, again, you can incorporate into your argument. Now, the goal is to develop your own position on the topic. In other words, you're not going to summarize the sources. You're not merely going to report what those sources said. You are going to take a position on the topic, and you're going to use those sources in order to support that position. Now, you can do that by either directly quoting the sources or by paraphrasing what the sources say. But whether you quote or paraphrase, it's absolutely essential that you remember to cite your sources. When you cite those sources, you can simply refer to them as source A, source B, or source C, or the College Board will provide you with a little description in parentheses that you can use to cite it instead. Like all of the essays on the AP Language and Composition test, the synthesis essay is graded on the new 6-point analytical rubric. Now, the 6-point analytical rubric is based on 3 sections: the thesis section, the evidence and commentary section, and the sophistication section. When you're writing your thesis, you want to be as specific as possible. Don't just say, oh, there's good arguments on both sides. Don't merely write a pro-con essay where you say these are the pros and these are the cons. You need to take a position, you need to make an argument, and you need to use those sources in order to support that position. On page 89 of the AP Language and Composition course description, it says, synthesis of sources should be a process of authentic inquiry motivated by questions for which readers genuinely want answers, not by desire to affirm pre-existing positions. Now, what do they mean by that? What they mean is that you shouldn't just go on the AP test with an axe to grind. It's not a good time to articulate your own political beliefs and opinions. What you should do instead is look at the evidence in the sources and develop an informed opinion based on the statistics, evidence, facts, and information that's provided for you. You see, really good critical thinkers let evidence guide their position. Really bad thinkers develop an emotional attachment to an argument and then seek out evidence that supports that emotional attachment. The AP College Board wants you to be a critical thinker, and they can see bad thinking from a mile away. So make sure that instead of grinding your own axe, instead of pursuing your own position, that you're engaged in what the College Board calls authentic inquiry. Let the sources in the synthesis packet guide your position. It's going to make your argument so much easier to defend, and it's going to make you a better critical thinker. When citing evidence on the synthesis essay, avoid summary at all costs. Don't merely recount what the source says. Instead, use really specific details from the sources. quote or paraphrase directly from the sources. Be sure to paraphrase accurately and always cite your sources. Even if you're merely paraphrasing or merely referring to information contained in one of the sources, you still have to cite that source. Keep in mind that this is a test of your ability as a researcher, and good academic researchers always cite their sources. It's absolutely not true that if you're paraphrasing a source or if you're changing the wording of a source that you don't have to cite it. If the AP College Board reader sees that you're misattributing a source or that you're not providing credit for the source when you're using information or ideas contained in that source, that's the quickest way to lose points on the evidence portion of the rubric. One of the key elements of the synthesis essay is to show how the sources relate to each other. Do the sources support each other? Do they contradict each other? Does one qualify another's argument? You need to show those relationships. On page 90 of the course description, it says, a coherent approach to synthesis requires students to consider the conversation among sources rather than regarding individual sources in isolation. Think about what that means. Sources in conversation. So if source A makes a claim and source C directly refutes that claim, then by all means you should incorporate that into your paper. And you should take one position or the other and say, although source A makes this argument, source C refutes that by indicating this, this, and this. And that is going to make your paper so much better. The easiest way to create a true synthesis and to create a conversation between the sources is to follow one simple rule. Include at least two sources per body paragraph. Now look, the temptation is going to be to have a body paragraph where you say, source A says this, this, and this, and then have a second body paragraph in which you say, source C says this, this, and this, and then a third body paragraph in which you say, source D says this, this, and this. But that's absolutely not a synthesis, and that's not going to convey to the AP reader that you understand how to synthesize information from sources. So here's what you need to do instead. In paragraph one, say, source A says this, and source C agrees. In the second paragraph, say, source B says this, and source D contradicts that and argues this instead, which supports my thesis. Do you see what I'm doing now? I'm creating a conversation. I'm showing how those sources relate. That absolutely is the key to a good score on the synthesis essay. The next section of the six-point rubric is commentary. Now, commentary is when you make explicit connections between the evidence that you're providing and the argument that you're making. Now, if you've ever studied Toulmin, you know that Toulmin calls this the warrant. It's the connection between the evidence and the argument, and it's an absolutely essential part of a synthesis essay. Time and again in student writing, I see students simply saying, source A says this, source B says this, source C says this. That's simply not enough to get a good score on the synthesis essay. What you need to do is say, both source A and B say this, and this relates to my argument in this specific way. In other words, explicitly state how and why that evidence supports your claim. Don't merely leave the quote sitting there or leave the source to explain itself. Don't assume anything. Make sure that the commentary is strong, that you're showing those relationships as clearly as you possibly can. That's the key to earning those commentary points on the synthesis essay. The last section of the AP synthesis rubric is what they call sophistication of thought, right? Or sometimes they refer to it as complexity. So what does that mean? How do we get sophistication? How do we develop complexity? Well, the key is to look at multiple perspectives, not just to pursue your own agenda, but to acknowledge the fact that there are good arguments on the other side, and then refute those good arguments. Consider the counterarguments. Try to refute those counterarguments. Try to engage in rebuttal. If there's one source in the packet in particular that disagrees with your stance, find a way to refute that source. That's going to be a good strategy. That's going to help you earn those sophistication and complexity points. If you're really looking for a way to pick up on those sophistication and commentary points, consider making a connection to a class concept. Now, what do I mean by a class concept? All I mean is something that you've learned in class, and it doesn't have to be AP Lang. Could be economics. So for example, you could be reading a synthesis essay and realize that one of the sources is making a Keynesian economic argument. You could then notice that one of the other sources is making an argument based in free market economics. And you could look at that and say, wow, that idea of Keynesian versus free market economic theory helps me understand how these sources relate. Well, then by all means, incorporate that into your essay. all of these controversial issues have larger implications. That's one thing I've found in all high-scoring AP essays, is that they don't simply argue a superficial level of the topic. They go deeper, they go broader, they go bigger. They explore the implications of the issue at a level that lower-scoring essays just don't do. The last part of your synthesis essay is going to be your conclusion. Now, I know that there's a lot of advice out there on the internet and in English classes about how to write a conclusion. And there's a lot of different parts of the conclusion, and there's different strategies and approaches. The best way to approach the conclusion on the AP test is very simple. Restate your thesis statement in different words. Try to write a better thesis than the one that you wrote in your intro. Now, why do I give this advice? You could, if you wanted, summarize your main points or do one of the more extended conclusions that a lot of English teachers recommend. But I want you to go to the 6-point rubric and read it very closely. And I want you to notice that there are absolutely no points given for a solid conclusion. So if you're spending your time writing a good conclusion, you're frankly wasting your time. What you should do instead is summarize the argument that you made, bring it all together, and produce that nice mic drop moment that just ends your paper on a really solid note. So those are the basics of the AP Language and Composition Synthesis Essay. To get more information about how to write an argument or analysis essay, check out our other videos. Until then, thanks for listening. I'm Dr. Clark.